In this video, we'll understand about dictionary, tuples and sets. Now, first of all, let's start off with dictionaries. Now, what are Python dictionaries? Python dictionaries are nothing but they are accessed by keys and not the offset position. If you remember, in our previous video session, we were working with lists and strings where we were accessing elements using indexing, whereas in case of dictionaries, we have key value pairs and we can access the elements using keys. For instance, we have this particular dictionary containing three keys naming name, last name, signified by L name, and age. So if you want to access this particular element ABC, you can specify the key associated with this element and it will give the outcome as its value. So it is an unordered collection of arbitrary objects containing key value pairs. Next we have, it has variable length, heterogeneous and arbitrarily nestable, which means that you can nest a dictionary inside another dictionary. For instance, if we have a dictionary over here naming record, we can have nested dictionary inside this particular dictionary. For instance, we have the name key inside which we have three different key value pairs, and then we have the job key containing two different key value pairs. Similarly, you can nest dictionaries as much as possible. Thirdly, dictionaries are mutable, which means that you can change the value of a particular element signified by a particular key. For instance, we have the name key associated with the value ABC. You can change the value associated with this particular key and change it. Now, there are various operations which you can perform over the dictionary. First of all, we have the keys operation. Now, as the name says, the keys operation will provide you with all the necessary keys present inside that particular dictionary. Similarly, we have the values operation, which will provide you with all the values present inside that dictionary. Then we have the items operation, which is going to give you key plus value present inside that dictionary, but the key and value are going to be present as tuples. Then we have the clear operation, which is going to clear your dictionary entirely and remove all items present in it. Then we have the update dictionary operation. Now, this update dictionary operation is what this function does. It will update your existing dictionary with another dictionary. Supposedly, you have two dictionaries, first being D and another being D2. It is going to replace all the elements present inside D with all the elements present inside D2, depending upon the common keys they have. Then we have d.get function. The .get function, what it does, you specify a particular key, it is going to provide the value associated with that key. In case that value is not present, that key is not present inside that particular dictionary, it is going to provide a default. Then similarly, we have the pop operation present inside dictionary. By using the pop keyword, you can delete a particular element which is associated with a particular key. You can specify the key present in the dictionary. If that key is not found, it is going to present you with a default. Let's try to work with all these operations. Let's first of all make a dictionary. Let's call our dictionary as D. And inside this, we'll be specifying the key value pairs. Let's have the first key as name and specify, say, the name as ABC. Let's have another key as last name and specify this as L_name. And let's have the last name as XYZ. And let's have another key over here, say age, and we'll specify the age as 22C. Done with it. So we have a dictionary available having age 22, L name XYZ, and name as ABC. Now, this is how you create a dictionary. You can also nest your dictionary as much as possible. So let's try to create a nested dictionary. So let's have a dictionary, say record, inside which we'll have the first key as name associated with a nested value. Now we want the name to have two key values pairs, the first name and the second name. So we specify first over here, let's say the first name as Bob, and let's have another key inside name as last name, specifying L name, and let's have the last name as William. Okay, so let's have another key of the record as job. And suppose we have two values associated with jobs, and we can give more than one value using a list over here, and we have already worked with list. Let's say the job is manager as well as engineer, so we can specify two jobs inside a list. So engineer over here, so we have a list of elements, and then we have the last key, say age, and we'll have a single element associated with it, say 45, hit enter. So when you're gonna go for record, look at this, we have a nested dictionary present over here. Now, as we know that dictionaries are mutable, so we can always change the values associated with a certain key. Let's say inside the D dictionary, we want the name to be changed. Let's give the name instead of ABC, let's say the name is Joe over here. Let's hit enter. So now if you're gonna see at D, look at this, the name is replaced from ABC to Joe. So that's how you change key value pairs. Now let's apply certain operations in dictionaries. So when you say the keys operation, it is going to present you with all the keys present. Look at this, we have age, L name and name. So it has presented us with all the keys. Similarly, you can look at values also. So when we say values, we have all the values inside it. Now, if you go for items, then it will give you keys plus values like tuples. So let's go for items. So as you can see, we have the key plus value pairs as tuples present over here. Next. Now, as soon as you use the clear operation, it is going to clear out the entire dictionary. Look at this, we don't have anything now in the dictionary. Why? Because we have used the clear operation. Now, suppose you have two dictionaries and you want to update the first dictionary with a second dictionary. Let's say we have one dictionary as D1, and suppose we have over here the first key name, say we have Joe, and we have age as 22. This is the first dictionary, and let's have another dictionary D2, and let's specify the first key name as John, and let's say we have the age as 30 over here. Let's hit enter. Fine, so we have two dictionaries, and now we'll replace the first by the second. So when we say d1.update d2, we have to write update. So update over here d2. So now when you refer D1, look at this, the values of D1 have changed. We had name as Joe and age as 22. It has changed the name as John and age as 30, which means it has replaced D1 dictionary with D2 dictionary. Similarly, you can use the get key function, get function basically. So when we say D.get and we want a particular key, let's say we want the name, we want the value associated with the name key, and if that key is not present, if the name key is not present, it is going to present a default. So we don't have a name key present inside D. Now why it is showing us default? Because we cleared out the D dictionary and we don't have anything present inside the D dictionary. So if you want something to be present, let's say we say d1.get. Inside D1 we have two keys, the first being name and the second being age. Suppose we want the age value to be displayed, so we'll simply say age, and if it doesn't find the age key, it will simply write default. So it shows us 30. Why? Because the age key is associated with the value 30. Now similarly, you can use the pop operation as well. So when we say d1.pop, inside pop you can specify the key associated with the element you want to get rid of. So let's say we want to get rid of age inside d1, and if the age element is not found, it will simply write default. We need to write it in single quotes. So we need to pop age, and if it is not found, we have default. So it has popped up 30 from d1. So if you can see over here, we don't have the age key anymore present inside d1. So that is how you work with different operations inside dictionaries. Let's move to tuples now. Okay, so like strings and list, tuples are also ordered collection of arbitrary objects. Now over here we have a tuple containing 5 values, 4 of which are numeric values and 5th is a character value. You can access tuples using offsets like indexing in strings and list. So we have the 0th element as 1, so it is showcasing a 1. And tuples are also immutable sequences like strings, so you cannot replace a particular value once it has been assigned. So as you can see, it is showing us with an error. And tuples are fixed length, heterogeneous and arbitrarily nestable, which means that you can nest tuples like you nested dictionaries. So tuples are also nestable. Now there are various operations in tuples as well. The first being the length. As the name says, it is going to find out the length of the tuple. Next we have the concatenation operation. So if you have two tuples and you want to concatenate the values of those tuples, you can simply use the addition operator. Next we have the repeat operation. If you want your tuple to get repeated numerous times, you can simply multiply that with the number of times you want it to get repeated. Then we have the index operation. So as soon as you're going to specify the keyword index, it is going to find out the index of that particular element you have passed in as a parameter. Next we have the count operation. So as the name says, it is going to find out how many times a particular value has occurred in a particular tuple. So let's try to work with these operations inside tuples. Okay, so let's make a tuple first of all. Let's say we have a tuple t, inside which we are simply passing in values 1, 3, 4, 4 and a string say hi. So look at this, we have these values present inside this tuple. So if you want to access a particular indexed value, say 0th index, look at this, we have the element 1 present at the 0th index. Now let's try to change a particular value. Let's say we want the first index to be replaced from 3 to say 5. So it says tuple object does not support item assignment, so you cannot mute a value inside a tuple. Now let's try to work with some operations. So if you want to find out the length of your tuple, say t, you can simply write len, and inside that you can pass the name of your tuple. So it says 5 because we have 5 values inside a tuple. Let's say we have 2 tuples, we have already 1 tuple. Let's have another tuple, say t1, and let's pass in 1, 7, 9, 8. Hit enter. Now let's say t plus t1. So we are basically concatenating our tuples. So look at this, it has concatenated both the tuples and the values of both the tuples are showing us collectively. So if you want to repeat a tuple, let's say we want to repeat a tuple t1, so we'll say t1 multiplied by 3. Hit enter. Look at this, it says 1798, 1798, 1798, which means that it has repeatedly repeated the tuple t1 3 times in the row. Similarly, you can have any integer and repeat your tuple any number of times. Now we have the index operator. Suppose we want to find out at what index the value 9 is present inside our tuple. hit enter, it says 2. We have 1798 present inside T1, and we have 01 second index we have present. We have 9 at the second index. Now suppose you want to count how many times a particular element has occurred. Suppose we say T1 dot count, and we want to see how many times 4 has occurred. It says 0, because we don't have a 4 inside this. Let's move to sets. That's all for tuples. Now what are sets? Sets are also unordered collection of objects. So you specify a set using the set keyword, inside single quotes you pass in the value of the set and give a particular name to the set by using a variable. Now set contains unique and immutable objects. So if you want to add a particular list inside a set, you cannot do that. For instance, over here what we are doing, we are trying to add a list containing two elements 1 and 2 inside set 1, which already contains A, B, C, D, E. You cannot do that because it is going to show you an error, unhashable type list, which means you cannot append a list inside a set. However, you can add a single element inside a set. Because sets are iterable, they can grow and shrink on demand. So if you want to add a single element instead of a list, you can always do that. Then we have sets are unordered and do not map key to values, therefore they are neither sequence nor mapping types, which means that you can neither access elements using indexing like we did in strings and list, and nor you can map them using keys like we did inside dictionaries. So they are neither accessible using keys nor accessible by indexing. They have various operations inside sets as well, the first one being the membership operator. You can simply say a particular element in set 1. It will specify true or false depending on whether that element is a part of the set or not. Next we have the superset operation. We can simply write the greater than symbol. Like we say set 1 is greater than set 2 when all the elements of set 2 are present inside set 1, which means that set 1 is the superset of set 2. Then we have set 1 is less than set 2 if all the elements of set 1 are present inside set 2, which means that set 1 is a subset of set 2. Then we have the union operation. When you are going to say two sets, set 1, union set 2, it is going to concatenate and combine and create a union of all these elements present inside set 1 as well as set 2. Then we have set 1 symmetric difference. Now what this is going to do, it is going to get rid of all the symmetric values present inside set 1 and set 2 and showcase us all the unsymmetric values. We'll see that how it does that in our implementation. Then we have the intersection operator. So as you write set 1 and set 2, it is going to simply print the intersection, that is the common values amongst set 1 and set 2. Then we have the difference, the set difference. What it's going to do, it is going to delete and get rid of all the elements present inside set 2 which are present inside set 1. So these are the operations of set. Let's try to implement these in Python. So let's first of all have a set. Let's say we have set 1 and we'll use the keyword set to create a set, and let's say we have A, B, C, D, E inside this set. Now let's try to append this to a list. So when we say set 1 is equal to set 1 dot add, let's add a list using the add function. So let's say we are adding 1 and 2. Hit enter. Look at this, it says unhashable type list, which means you cannot append a list to a already assigned set. Now if you want to add a single element, let's say we want to add set 1.add, we have say f over here. Now if you can have a look at set 1, look at this, we have f appended to our already assigned set. Now you cannot access them by indexes. So if you say set 1 0th index of set 1, look at this, it says set objects does not support indexing, so it is not going to support indexing. Let's try to use some operations. So we have A present inside the set. So when we'll say A in set 1, look at this, it says true. Why? Because A is a character which is present in set 1. Similarly, let's have another set let's say we have a subset of set 1, let's say we have set 2, and we have A and B present inside this set. So if we say set 1 is greater than set 2, look at this, it says true. Why? Because all the elements of set 2 are present in set 1. Similarly, if we say set 1 is less than set 2, it is going to show us a false, because set 1 is a superset of set 2. Then we have the union operation. So if we say set 1 union set 2, look at this, we have BFCDAE, all the elements of set 1 and set 2 combined together. Now if we say symmetric difference, so we have set 1 symmetric difference set 2, look at this, we have two symmetric values present inside set 1 and set 2. If you can have a look at set 1, look at this, we have A, B, C, D, E in set 1, and in set 2 we have A, B. So A and B are two characters which are symmetric, both in set 1 and set 2. All those values which are not symmetric are C, D, E, F which we added later on obviously. So we have C, D, F and E as unsymmetric values, so it is going to show us the symmetric difference as F, C, D and E. Similarly, you can go for the intersection operation. So when we say set 1 intersection set 2, now A and B are common values, so it is going to show us as intersection. Then we have the set difference. So when we say set 1 subtracted set 2, we are subtracting set 2 from set 1, which means that the values inside set 2 which are A and B are not going to be present inside set 1. Now, so we have F, C, D, E. It has got rid of A and B. So this is how you work with sets, tuples and dictionaries in Python. That's it for this video.